My name is Enzo Amore, and I am a certified G and a bona fide star. And you can't teach that. And this right here, this is Big Cass, and he's 7 foot tall. And you can't teach that. Bada boom, realest guys in a room. How you doing?
As you know, King, Enzo Amore is never afraid to say what's on his mind.
Yeah, and for some reason, this kid's internal filter is switched to the off position.
This is one of the most talked about entrances in all of WWE.
And for our so-called opponents tonight, we have one word to describe them, and I'm gonna spell it out for you. S-A-W-F-T.
There's the bell, and Enzo Amore wants to prove just how real the realest guy in the room is.
Yeah, and I've seen average single superstars turn into absolute beasts with a partner. Oh, this should be a good one.
All these tag team superstars are living in the shadow of the APA, but some of them carry themselves all right.
Well, all that being said, these Miami fans have left South Beach and are sending the Richter scale north with every cheer, every stomp and scream.
I wonder what Colin Cassidy is thinking at this point of the match. In a tag team, being a good partner is as important as anything else. How can he do his part tonight in this one?
I know it's early, but he and his partner really seem to be clicking tonight, Michael.
We're looking at a tag team right now that's primed to be one of the best in all of sports entertainment.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have to see Colin Cassidy live and in person. He's like a tree with legs. He's got to be nearly 7 feet tall.
Yeah, and you can't teach that, Cole. At least that's what Enzo Amore likes to say. And now, Simon Gotch pushing forward.
You don't see that move every day. And that's why the adage holds true. There's a first time
for everything.
I think you're right. I believe that's the first time he's ever attempted this.
He's certainly showing us something new from his, and the shoulder's up in time.
Well, as long as it's up before that three count, that's all that matters.
Well, I've never seen him do that before. Looking to catch him off guard there, I guess.
Yeah, but I think a little too early in this match for that to be successful.
Right to the midsection. This is a beating inside and out.
Yeah, external and internal.
Plenty of fight left.
You're right, still near 100%.
Looks like he's starting to sweat now.
We all know, though, this guy has plenty of fight left in him.
But it's important to know that this match has been so evenly contested so far, you really can't pick a winner.
And on top of that, John, these two guys couldn't be any more evenly matched at this point.
One, 2, 3.
Nice. Let's do this inside the ring.
Nice dodge there.
Turning it around. It's Aiden English with the reversal.
Enzo Amore in trouble now. And you have to assume his partner is just itching to get in there right about now.
And at this point, it looks to me like this match is as even as it could get.
That's a good point. And I must say that I'm a little surprised his finisher was so ineffective earlier.
There may be no stopping him.
Hey, look at Enzo Amore here. Yeah, you're not going to win many matches out there.
Since it's not a false count anywhere match, I'd have to agree with you. When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows. I don't remember the last time he executed that maneuver. He's setting a mess.
What a counter!
Fatigue setting in on the face of Enzo Amore. His hopes of winning this tag team.
We got a cover.
And tagged in is Aiden English.
What a collision! He can end it here.
Pinfall and the victory.
Here are your winners, Aiden English and Simon Gotch, the Bond Villains.
I love a good tag team match, and this one was unforgettable. I mean, these teams gave us everything they had, and the WWE Universe is the true winner in this one.
And don't forget, you and I, we have the best seats in the house. These two superstars have become best friends.
What a match here from Miami. Thanks to all of you for joining us tonight.